Another clue is because they have exclamation points and want around Juan's statement, and Ella's just like,
meh. Yeah.
I mean, really, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then if you look over here, there's this dash, which means that she actually interrupts him. He, like, starts saying something, and she's like, eh, I don't have time. So, yeah, you can kind of see how that goes. So, I will tell you what it actually says, and you can see how it matches up with what you were thinking. But it says, hola, Juan dijo. So, hello, Juan said. Hola, ella contestó con una sonrisa fría. Hello, she said, or she answered, with a cold smile. Mira, lo siento sobre... Look, I'm sorry about... No tengo tiempo ahorita, tengo que estudiar. I don't have time right now. I have to study.
He's apologizing.
So he's trying to apologize, but does that kind of match with what you're thinking? Like, he kind of looks a little bit embarrassed, or I can see how you could. Maybe he does have a crush on her.
You never know. Love your spat.
Yep. All right. So we're about out of time, so we're going to wrap it up there instead of moving on to the third one. But what do you guys think is the takeaway from this activity? Like, did you learn anything new? What do you think about the reading strategies that we used?
That we can use context clues to help us
figure out. Yeah. And like, even though we don't know very much Spanish, we were able to get the gist of what was happening just based on what we actually knew.
Yeah. I think you'll usually find that you actually know more than you think you know, and especially when you try to use other clues and other cues, then you're able to synthesize it and make it into something that you can start to understand at least. Thank you guys.
Yeah.